Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I'm going to be doing a part 2 to Mariah Carey's Best Live Vocals. I did part 1 the other day and I will link it down below in the description so you guys can check that out as well if you haven't seen it yet. But this time I have a fan-made compilation that I'm going to be reacting to. So let's just jump right in. Oh, now, sorry, real quick, before this continues any further, if there's accidentally some overlap in these performances and the last performances, I haven't seen this video yet. I don't know if there will be, there probably will be, but I'm sorry about that if there's any overlap, but at least I can give a more in-depth review because I've already seen it, I guess. I don't know. I might end up cutting them out if I talked about them in detail in my last video, but yeah. Yeah, this was in my last video. And this was also the clip that I had seen of hers from, I don't know if it was a Rumi video that I watched, Rumi Official, or what, but I have seen this clip before in another reaction video from her, of hers. And that's kind of what made me want to do a reaction video for her in the beginning, like in the get-go. Because I saw that clip and I was thinking, oh man, she's really good at whistle notes. I wonder what else her voice can do. And I decided to react to her. I like how she used her hands to sing. It's really, it helps guide. Oh, I like that. That cut out, it cuts to breathiness kind of. That sounded pretty. I feel like a lot of people, when they talk about her voice or they're showing these compilations of her, it's always like the whistle notes, the high notes, the belts, all the sort of stuff that's like really cool to watch and stuff. But I might do a video on just her actual songs, like straight through, because I'm curious into how her just normal voice sounds like when she's singing but not belting or not doing like whistle notes or something. I want to know how her like normal range is when she's just doing like chest voice, not pushing. I really want to see what. What that sounds like. I don't know, I didn't finish my sentence. I don't understand how people like her. I know that she's got a lot of practice and knows what her voice can do and stuff, but I'm curious as to like what precautions and like steps they would take when going on tour. I'm sure she's been in the singing business for years and years, so I'm sure she's been on tour before. Kind of like Ariana Grande, when she does those songs that take a lot of effort to do when she's live, and I know that I think she kind of scaled back on how many songs she does that take a lot of effort to do, but I'm curious as to like if there's anybody who, I don't know, has experience in it. Like, what do you do whenever you I'm assuming you would put more days in between your shows or something like that, like take breaks more often if your voice can't take it or something like that. But I don't know, it'd be interesting to figure out what like the steps that singers take whenever they have songs that are like really taxing on their voice. Her whistle notes are incredible, but the backup vocals, the harmonization of them was so good. We can conquer. See, that's what I'm talking about. That's like super low register. That sounds so good though. Yeah. Like, in the compilations I watched, or the compilation I watched in my last video, it was all just whistle notes and belting and stuff, and there was no, like, normal or low range to really showcase her tone and stuff. That was a flawless transition. That the tone on that note is so pretty. Hand singing, I do that too. It makes everything, I don't know why it makes things easier, but when you're doing like a run or something, or notes closer together, maybe not a full run, but just notes closer together, it's easier to let your hand help you guide your voice. I don't know why, but it's fun to see somebody else do that. Was this the year that she was having a mic issues, or like they're having technical difficulties with her? Because I watched that happen live. That's the end of the compilation, but I actually would like for you guys to request, if you can, some songs of hers that maybe showcase more of her normal, but her like mid-range vocals, and not like belty whistle notes. Those are great and I love those too, but I'm just so curious to hear what her tone is outside of that. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I want to thank you guys for requesting this. There's only 2 videos left in the month of December, and then I'm going to actually change up my posting schedule, I think. If you guys liked this video, you can give it a big thumbs up. If you want to see more videos of her, you can subscribe down below, because the videos that you suggest, I will react to those next. And also, if you guys want to suggest videos that there are actual links to them, like their YouTube videos, compilations, audio songs, whatever, and you want me to react to them, a lot of times YouTube thinks that comments with links are spam, and they will completely delete them, and I won't be able to see them or click on the link. So I actually created a form, which I can pin in the comments in the below this video, but where you guys can actually post the link to the video, what the video is about, and yeah, just so if you guys want to request videos, it's an easier way to do it where I actually see it and YouTube won't delete them, which is very annoying, because I love